हाय एवरीवन, चैप्टर नंबर 2 दैट इज ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल चैप्टर। वी विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द थिंग्स अबाउट द पॉलिनोमियल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, पॉलिनोमियल स्टार्ट्स एट योर लेवल। जो आपने शुरू किया वो हमेशा स्टार्ट किया आपने पहले 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th और अब 10th में आपका पॉलिनोमियल चैप्टर। बेसिकली ये लीनियर इक्वेशन ऑफ वन वेरिएबल, लीनियर इक्वेशन ऑफ वन टू वेरिएबल के साथ लिंक होकर के पॉलिनोमियल चैप्टर बनता है। पॉलिनोमियल चैप्टर बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, 6 मार्क्स का चैप्टर है और 6 मार्क्स आपके बोर्ड एग्जाम्स में आने वाले चैप्टरों में से हैं। बहुत ईजी चैप्टर कंसिडर होता है कि बहुत हार्ड चैप्टर इसको हम कंसिडर नहीं कर सकते हैं, इसीलिए भी बहुत अच्छा होता है। दूसरा, स्कोर बहुत ज़्यादा आप कर सकते हैं इस चैप्टर के अंदर, बहुत जल्दी जो है इजीली सम्स इसमें आ जाते हैं और आप इसमें बढ़िया स्कोर कर सकते हैं। नाउ सबसे पहले पॉलिनोमियल जो है कि उसको हम क्या कह सकते हैं कि कोई भी कांस्टेंट टर्म है एंड एन इज़ अ होल नंबर देन इट इज़ कॉल्ड ए वेरिएबल ऑफ एक्स। बेसिकली कोई भी ऐसा नंबर जिसके साथ वेरिएबल हो, कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म हो या फिर उसका पावर हो, ऐसे सब नंबरों को हम कंसिडर कर सकते हैं कि वो एक पॉलिनोमियल नंबर है। पॉलिनोमियल के साथ साथ उसके टाइप्स भी हैं, जैसे आपने बहुत पहले हमने पढ़ा था मोनोमियल, बाइनोमियल एंड ट्राइनोमियल। मोनोमियल, मोनो मीन्स एक, बायो मीन्स दो, ट्राइनो मीन्स तीन। मोनोमियल का एग्जाम्पल अगर हम लें तो 4x, जैसे मान लो हम ले लेते हैं 4x, ये आपका मोनोमियल का एग्जाम्पल है। सपोज 4x प्लस 2 ये बाइनोमियल का एग्जाम्पल है। सपोज x स्क्वायर प्लस 4x और प्लस 2 ये आपका ट्राइनोमियल का एग्जाम्पल है। तो मोनोमियल, बाइनोमियल, ट्राइनोमियल एक ऐसा सिचुएशन है। उसके साथ साथ आगे अगर हम बढ़े उसमें तो हर एक पॉलिनोमियल के कुछ पावर्स होते हैं, अलग अलग पावर्स होते हैं, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 जैसे पावर्स होते हैं। एनी पॉलिनोमियल विच इज़ हैविंग द पावर 1 इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल। एनी पॉलिनोमियल विच इज़ हैविंग द पावर 2 इज कॉल्ड कंसिडर्ड एज अ क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल एंड एनी पॉलिनोमियल विच इज़ हैविंग पावर 3 इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ क्यूबिक पॉलिनोमियल। सो दीज आर द 3 डिफरेंट थिंग एंड वी कैन गेट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग्स ऑल्सो। जस्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट इज 4x, सो इट इज़ अ लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल। Suppose it is x square plus 1, it is quadratic polynomial because we have the power 2, and if it is x cube plus 4x plus 1, it means the power is 3, so we have to consider it as a cubic polynomial. So these are the polynomial values which already we have done. Now after this we will have some of the things which are very essential for you, that you have to place certain values in that particular polynomial and you have to find out the values. These are the sums also which can be asked in this particular chapter. Just for example, if we consider that which are the considered the zeros of the polynomial, in that case we will have certain numbers and that number will be placed in the particular polynomial, and if zero comes then it will be considered as a zero polynomial. If zero is not there then it is considered as a not zeros of the polynomial. So if zero is there then you can consider that x minus 1 is a factor of that polynomial, and if 0 is not there then we can consider that x plus 1 is a factor of that polynomial. So these are the different things which we can solve it. Now after that we have to some important things that we have to do. Suppose we have a graph, and already we have done a graph in 9th standard also. And if we have this graph, then we can consider this graph into two different way. That is, this is a part, one part, so we will consider it as a quadrant. So quadrant, so one quadrant, two quadrant, three quadrant and four quadrant, we have to move anti-clockwise, not clockwise. So quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3, quadrant 4. In the same way, if the graph of any quadratic polynomial if it is ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 in the quadratic polynomial and a is not equal to 0, this is most important thing. A never will be 0, that is when we have to be considered. Is parabola either opening upward, then if any parabola, this is opening upward, this is considered as a parabola, then it is a is greater than 0 will be there. So you have to remember it. And opening downward, if the parabola is like this way, in that case a will be less than 0. These two things you have to remember. And other different aspects of this is that the zeros of the quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus 0, a not equal to 0, are precisely the x coordinates and where the parabola representing y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c intersect at the x-axis. Now, so far as if we consider the first exercise of the chapter, then we can consider that we have a certain graph, and in that graph one is like this way, one is like this way, and other is certain like this way, this will be like this way, and so there are another different term. Now you can see that we have this is x axis and this is x dash, this is y and this is y dash. So x axis and x and x dash, y and y dash, how many times this curve is intersecting the x axis, that will be the most important part. In the very first one we can see that it is intersecting only one x axis, so it will be the answer one. The second one, that is this one, so the one intersecting point is this, another intersecting point is this, so the answer will be 2. The third one is this one, so I can see it is intersecting at 3 different points. One is here, other is here, and third one is here, so it will be 3 intersecting point. Means as many times as it intersects the x-axis, we have to consider the number of zeros. So this is all about the first exercise. And the third, if we consider the fourth one, that is 1, fifth one is also 1, you can see, and the sixth one is 4. These are the things that will be ended up for the exercise 1. Now, another different thing that we have to consider for exercise, further exercises are, sorry, but it is a very rainy season, and so you can थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट आपको हो रहा होगा क्योंकि हमारा जो ब्लैक बोर्ड है थोड़ा अनटाइडी हो जाता है क्योंकि वॉइस की वजह से, बट नो मोर और लेस इट इज ईजियर. नाउ सब रिलेशनशिप थोड़े आपको याद रखने हैं, जो आपके टेक्स्ट बुक में रिलेशनशिप दिया हुआ है, दैट इज अल्फा प्लस बीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए, अल्फा प्लस बीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए, देन अल्फा इंटू बीटा दिया होगा, अल्फा प्लस बीटा प्लस गामा दिया होगा, देन अल्फा एंड बीटा प्लस बीटा गामा एंड गामा अल्फा दिया, और सभी के वैल्यूज आपको यहाँ उसके जो सामने दिए होंगे, अल्फा प्लस बीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए, अल्फा इंटू बीटा इज इक्वल टू जो है सी अपॉन ए, आप लिखोगे सी अपॉन ए, उसी तरह से अल्फा बीटा गामा का भी वैल्यू दिया हुआ है. अल्फा बीटा गामा का होता है आपका जो कोएफिशिएंट अल्फा प्लस बीटा प्लस गामा, इसका होता है माइनस बी अपॉन ए, एंड अल्फा बीटा एंड बीटा गामा जो है उसका सिचुएशन फिर से सी अपॉन ए, एंड दिस इज द सेम थिंग. सो इस तरह से अलग अलग रिलेशनशिप जो आपको इसमें इस चैप्टर के अंदर करना है, आगे बढ़ते हुए ये सब याद रखना है. आप उसको ऐसे भी याद रख सकते हैं कि अल्फा प्लस बीटा इज इक्वल टू कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स अपॉन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर, कैसे होता है वो मैं आपको एक इसके तौर पे दिखा देता हूँ कि किस तरह से आप अल्फा प्लस बीटा रिलेशनशिप में कर सकते हैं। जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि ए एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी एक्स एंड प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू जीरो एक सिचुएशन है। आप इस सिचुएशन को फोर एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव एक्स प्लस सिक्स इक्वल्स टू जीरो के ऊपर कंसिडर कर सकते हैं। द फर्स्ट वन यू कंसिडर एज ए, द सेकेंड वन यू कंसिडर एज बी एंड कंसिडर दिस वन एज सी। So if it is as alpha plus beta, then minus b upon a, so minus b means 5, if we consider this one, so minus 5 upon a, a is 4, so minus 5 upon 4. In the same way, alpha into beta, that is c upon a, it means 6 upon 4, so c upon a is 6 upon 4. Like this way, so many different, alag alag, bahut sare alag alag, aapke isme aayenge, jo पॉलिनोमियल्स और सभी पॉलिनोमियल्स के अलग अलग फिर नंबर्स और उस तरह से उसके अलग अलग सिचुएशंस आएंगे। अब अगर रिलेशनशिप से आगे बढ़ते हुए अगर हम बात करें तो सबसे पहले आपको इसके अंदर जो फॉर्मूलाज हैं वो आपको दिमाग में रखना है। ए प्लस बी द होल स्क्वायर, ए माइनस बी द होल स्क्वायर, ए प्लस बी इंटू ए माइनस बी इज इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर एंड सो ऑन। बात साथ ही साथ आपको जो इस एक्सरसाइज के अंदर करना है कि अलग अलग पॉलिनोमियल्स के अलग अलग जो फॉर्मूलाज हैं मैं फिर से आपको रिकॉल करवा देता हूँ। तो ये सब फॉर्मूलाज आपका है, दैट इज ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर, देन वी हैव ए माइनस बी होल स्क्वायर, देन ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर, देन एक्स प्लस ए एंड देन एक्स माइनस ए। वी कैन कंसिडर दिस वन ऑल्सो, वी कैन कंसिडर एक्स प्लस a and we can consider x plus b and so on. Different formulas are there. If any of the formulas that is I have written and you are not able to write those formulas applicable to formula in the sum, then we have to find out the middle term. Then as we have done the middle term in 8th standard so far, so in that situation we have to find out the relations and in the we have to coordinate that particular thing with this sum. Exercise 2.2, that is the find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial, verifying the relationship between the zeros. The very first one is x square minus 2x and minus 8. The other question is x square minus 2x and minus 8. This is your question. I can easily, if we make the bifurcation of these two, so I can easily do this, that x square minus 4x plus 2x and minus 8. So x will be common, x minus 4 and plus 2 will be common, so x minus 4, so x plus 2 and x minus 4 equals to 0. I have to consider then x plus 2 equals to 0 and x minus 4 equals to 0, so I can write x is equal to minus 2 and I can write x is equal to 4. These two things we can do. The second question is 4x square minus 4s, 4s square minus 4s plus 1. So consider this 4s square minus 4s and plus 1. If we do the multiplication 4 ones of 4, then we can easily split it, that is 4s square minus 2s minus 2s and plus 1. If we make the difference of this, that will be 2s in the bracket, it will be 2s minus 1. No common is there, so I have to consider minus 1, so it will be 2s minus 1. One thing we have to remember, that whenever we have certain brackets and inside the bracket every time the sign will be same, that is 2s minus 1 and 2s minus 1. We can consider the plus 1 in the other different way, that's just for example, if it is 2s plus 1, I can also have the common 1 plus 2s and 2s plus 1 both. But if it is minus 2s minus 1, in that case we cannot consider it as the we can consider it in the plus 1. So we have to make 2s minus 1, it means 2s minus 1. But if it is in your sum 1 minus 2s, in that case it is wrong, so it will be 2s minus 1 and 2s minus 1. So s is equal to 1 by 2 and here s is equal to 1 by 2. So these are the different things in question number 2. if we consider the question number 3, that is 6x square minus 3 minus 7x. Let us rub this one first of all. So another question is 6x square minus 3. Let us consider 6x square minus 3 and plus 7x. I think this is the sum. It is minus 7x. It is minus 7x. Now, so first of all, I will arrange this sum in particular polynomial form. In that case, I have to do, that is 6x square minus 7x and minus 3. If we make the multiple of these two, 6 3 is 18 will be there, and 6 3 is 18 means 9 2 is 18 will be applicable. 6x square minus 9x plus 2x and minus 3. So 3x is common, so it will be 2x minus 3 plus 1 will be common, 2x minus 3. So 3x plus 1 and 2x minus 3. So x is equal to minus 1 by 3, x is equal to minus 3 by 2. These are the two different things of this. Another some important sum is there, that is 4x square. It is somewhat different, that is 4u square plus 8u. 4u square plus 8u. So if we consider this 4u square minus 8u, so it is that we have to bring the common 4 here. So 4 will be there, 4u common will be there, so it will be u minus 2. So 1 u will be 0 and another u will be 2. So u will be 0 and u will be 2. Now two of the sums that you have to solve by your side. Question number 2 we have, that is find the quadratic polynomial of each of the following given numbers as the sum and the product of the number is this. Now product and sum is there. So in that case, we have to do this, that is alpha plus beta. It means alpha plus beta is given 1 by 4. Alpha plus beta is given 1 by 4 and alpha into beta is given minus 1. So we know that alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a is equal to minus b upon a, and alpha into beta is equal to c upon a is equal to c upon a. So we have to find out the a, b and the c here. So a will be 4 and b will be your minus 1, b will be minus 1 and c will be minus 1. A will be minus 1, B will be minus 1 and C will be minus 4, sorry. C will be minus 4. How can you do? You have to do the multiplication of this, that you can see that if B is equal to 1 and C A is equal to 4. In that case, if we do the multiplication, cross multiplication, and we will have the cross multiplication factor, and after doing the cross multiplication, we can have this A is equal to 4, B is equal to minus 1 and C is equal to minus 4. In the same way, we can consider as root 2. So alpha plus beta is equal to alpha plus beta is equal to root 2, and alpha into beta is equal to alpha into beta is equal to minus 1 by 3, sorry, 1 by 3. So again, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a, we will consider is equal to minus b upon a. And alpha into beta is equal to, that is C upon A. So we have to write A, we have to write B, we have to write C. So if we consider root 2, we have 1 also here. So in that case, A will be 3, because if you multiply across root 2, will be A is equal to 3. A is equal to 3, then B is equal to 2 root 3 root 2, B is equal to 3 root 2, and C is equal to 1. So after doing the multiplication, we can have this. So with this particular another sum that is given on in question number 2, we have to continue it and so on. The also we have to make the equation, I think so. So the equation will be after doing this, you have to make the equation of these two. So let us do the equation also. If we want to make the equation of this particular one, will be that ax squared means we have to consider 4x squared minus 4x and minus 4. This will be your equation. Then again, a is equal to 3, it will be 3x squared, then plus 3 root 2x and plus 1. So this is all about. So it is minus 3 by 2. So it will be minus 3 by 2. So here it will be like this. B is as ax squared. I have written the standard form of the polynomial, that is ax squared plus bx and plus c. So instead of a, I have placed 3. Instead of b, I have placed 3 root 2. Instead of c, I have placed 1. So with this, the exercise is over, and all of the sums that you have to solve like this way only. Let us move to exercise that is 3.3, that will be in the next lecture.